Now you dey cheat, now me dey beg. Make una check out my banje. Shebi na me dey find CCLO. No be say them no dey rush me. Shebi na your love.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel. The kids are outside playing. I love the sound of their voice. I really just love hearing the kids shouting and playing football by my window. So I'm not complaining at all, but it might distract us. Apologies for that in advance. So today we're going to be reviewing three books. This, one of our favorites. This, by another of our favorites. This, by a third favorite. Basically, started reading them this week. I started on Monday, finished this by like Tuesday, and then I jumped into this because I left this at work and then took this home. I forgot it at home. Usually it's at work in between my work that I read all these books and make notes and stuff. So yeah, I forgot that, so I just went into this, and really I think that was actually a very good decision. So I finished this yesterday, and yeah, I just thought let's just quickly review this without even reading this, because guys, I don't think this is like that deep. When I do book reviews, I do it one by one. I go so in depth, like you don't even have to read the book again. But because I really love these people, I want you guys actually make a decision, support these people, and like buy the books if you like what you see. So we're gonna start with this one, which was the first one I read. It's Heart and Whole Soul by Patricia Bright. Patricia Bright is a UK based content creator. My favorite part about this book, guys, is an introduction. If you actually follow Patricia Bright, there are some of the stories on the book you'd have heard already, but just hearing them in depth again was actually very inspirational. The book is made up of 15 chapters, and then she has like time to say goodbye, and then her reading list, which she basically wants you to tap into. In between the chapters, she puts things called life lessons, and she explained the reason she wrote the book, which is just to pull back the curtain on her experiences as a businesswoman and a content creator. Before I bought this book, I thought the book was going to guide me more on like my content creative. She did that a bit, but what I really felt with the book was the hustle story. Her father at some point was deported when she was 6, then he came back and then wrote some fiction books, and the irony of it, they were UK immigration. Her mom, 2 kids, struggled, cleaned, did nursing, did so many things. Eventually gathered money to buy her a house for like 17k. After a while, she sold the house for 250 grand, and then she went into real estate. So like stories like that were really inspiring, to be very honest. Aside that, her personal stories, the first business she invested in, the first scam that ever happened in her life, how she invested so much in like fake MAC products, and then it came back to bite her in the ass, because when the thing came, the MAC wasn't even spelled as MAC. So you can imagine like maybe spending like so much money on things, something like that. And then she also talked about even content creating, the first time she actually lost so much money. She had finished doing all the content and everything, only for the agency or something to go bankrupt. So obviously like they were ruining her. Other few experiences with relationship, with being in school, doing content creating, resigning from her full-time very amazing job, even getting the internship, nailing an interview. Young girls will really benefit from this, because I really love those tips she wrote. She gave a lot of rules with different things. Even when she started the introduction of the book and talked about like hustle, she said the three things that were really important about hustle was your brand, your business, and your beliefs. Obviously you can explain that yourself. And gathering from the experiences her parents had gone through, and obviously she had witnessed as well, she drew some conclusions like it is within your power to save your own situation, that everyone has gone through experiences that cannot be corrected by a pretty filter. And she also mentioned of her favorite quotes, life and death are in the power of your tongue. Let me just quickly summarize each chapter. The first chapter, Natural Born Hustler. The thing big, take small steps. Of the MAC business she tried to do, which was, you know, such a mess, but still she stood up and still continued what she was doing. The second one is like, yes, I work for myself on the internet. She talks about finding your grind. She also gave a like little list of things to ask yourself before you find your grind. And even if you want to do it for money, you have to actually love it and be passionate about it, because it takes consistency. Also says something about taking a leap of faith in whatever it is you're doing, because the road will never be clear cut. No matter how many people have done it, you're the one doing it now. To your experience are going to be different and unique to yourself. But that once you have following, it's easy to start something using that following, because these people trust you. It's very important to build that. The science beat, something like that. So like, nothing is new under the sun. And then plan. She went on and on about planning. The fifth one was moving your audience to the next level. I didn't really find that chapter inspiring at all. And the sixth was online versus real life, learning to say no, learning to set boundaries. Obviously set these boundaries based on your values, your niche, and then the plan of your brand. So sometimes you don't just say yes because there's money. You think about who you're serving, why you're actually there. The seventh one was create your wealth, and over there she talked about basically food, clothing, and shelter. That's how I just put it in my head, you know, home economics now. Watching money, watching how you spend, your transport, just cutting down on things really. She talked about how she really lost underground, the transport, like instead of driving every time, your clothing, just buying quality stuff. Yeah, so basically just taking care of yourself, creating your wealth, saving when you have to, which is so important, guys, saving. Chapter 8 was like a career versus going it alone, the choice on whether to leave your full-time job to face this or how to do both of them together. Obviously, it's always better to start doing both of them together and be sure the other one, when you get all your time, you'll be able to pay your bills. Chapter 9 was how to run your empire, and then she talks about 5 pitfalls. I think you guys should just grab that. I think I'll mention maybe a list of something I really, really liked at some point. The 10th one, she said, A Woman's World. I think she talks about the struggles of being a lady. A summary for that chapter, learn to trust yourself. And you really don't have to be girly to be a woman. 11 was discovering who you are. In every chapter, she had life lessons. Chapter 12 was staying the course in style. Lead thing I took from there was you should be the gritty in integrity. And the 13th, the power of the pep talks, obviously. Don't look down on yourself. Forget your negative. There was one of my videos. That video titled Throw Away Your Vision Board. The most important point in that video was do not believe the negative things you think about yourself in your head. Focus on the positives because everybody out there is ready to show you what you cannot do. Pep talk yourself. Like just ginger your life because there's so many good things about you. So I think that's what she's trying to say on this chapter. Chapter 14 was streamline the stress away. Generally, it was just saying do more by doing less. And there's one, I don't know if it's one of my videos I was talking about, like creativity. Sometimes what you don't put out there is actually shows how creative you are. Like just keep some off it. Chapter 15, she said feel good from the inside. So obviously what you eat, what you take in, what you watch, what you surround yourself with, who you follow on Instagram. Take care of yourself first of all and everything will be easier to deal with. One of my favorite chapters was chapter 7, the one titled Create Your Own Wealth. And then at some point she was challenging the readers to try to save 5k pounds. So 5k pounds in Naira is about 2.3 million and she gave like 5 steps to save it. Okay, the first one is save yourself. Second one, turn your trash into treasure, selling on eBay, Depop, things like that. The third one is your time is really money. The fourth one is can you do more? And the fifth one is turn trader. Like, just try and see how what you can actually give. It mustn't be physical products. Just ask yourself, what do I like? What do I know about? What my people want to buy from me or learn from me? Choose a niche. Just don't be everywhere. You can be a jack of all trades, but it's always good for people to remember you for something. First of all, this thing, it kept falling out of the book up and down the whole place while I was reading it. Wasn't the most practical cover. Maybe they should have stuck it to it or something. It was a bit heavy for my bag. And if you look at the book, like, it's just very bland. Like, you guys, there are no pictures. But then she had, like, these beautiful pictures at the end of it. This one with Grace, her husband. I think this was when Glamour UK came to her house. This is just the picture. And then this is when she made the cover of Glamour. Obviously, this picture at the front is very beautiful. Love the fact that she was wearing black. And I love the fact that it's pastel. It's just very girly. And then the font, everything is really nice. Guys, let me just see if I can randomly find one life lesson to read for you. A younger girl will probably appreciate this book more. Okay, this life lesson was from chapter 3, The Importance of Social Media. So it says, don't seek popularity. And this goes for online or in real life. Just for the sake of being popular or promoting yourself. What value can you add? That's what is important. So yeah, this is a very crucial message, but yeah, a lot of the things were just like things you already knew. And then for interview, she also gave like a list of interview questions, how to like smash an interview for that. So I think that'd be good for some people. And then the grind thing, there are a lot of rules on the book that you can always just glance through and get something from. So yeah, that's Heart and Hustle. I pre-ordered it and then they sent me a refund of maybe like £3, I don't even know, so maybe like £11 ish. I bought this book for. The second book I read was this one, The New Fashion Rules by Victoria Margaret. She's also called At Indofro on all her social media platforms. She had written this book a while ago. I guess there was just so much going on in my life. I didn't even order it, pre-order it or anything. Last week, I was watching her on YouTube again. And then, I don't know, you know how you just start getting fond of someone. Like, this person has substance. Let's get to know her more. She has a book. Okay, let's buy the book. This is the book. Lovely. No stress with the opening. I love this pastel blue, yellow gold font. Written nice. I opened this book. What did I see? The first page picture. Like, it's so encouraging. You're reading a fashion book. You should see pictures. The pages of the book, the quality, lovely. I don't know what to even call it. Like, it's not glossy. Neither is it matte. Just in between, but proper quality picture. And then the pictures, nice, well filtered. I think it was one preset they used for all the pictures with some bluish, orangish kind of vibe that was also soft. She dedicated the book to all fashion students, the enthusiasts, the creatives, the bosses, the marketers, the online shoppers, the clothing admirers, fashion show attendees, the writers, and the devoted fans of the fashion world. That's you and I, hopefully. I don't know if you're a devoted fan or you're just watching this video, so it's my channel. So she basically read fashion in the University of Manchester and went ahead to do her PhD. For her PhD, the question she was answering was how a brand could entice people to buy from their mobile apps and what the brands could do to enhance the customer's experience and enjoyment. So I think it was those days where fashion online was like long before you go shopping, go to one, drive to one far place and everything. So she just wanted to answer that question, and then she researched it and researched it, and then I wasn't surprised at all, because really when you watch her videos, it's just like reading Susie Bubble's blog. Like, that girl is goals. They just talk fashion, like, not just the way me and you talk about it, not just those flipping trends you read everywhere. Mm-mm. They know their stuff. Like, this book, okay, let's just go into the book. She called the chapters rules, like six chapters, six rules, and then she ended with like her last stuff. I'm gonna go through the titles with you and then just tell you any other thing I remember that really stuck with me. First one, be accessible and easy to find. On this chapter, she mentioned like social media, having one social media. A lot of things she talks about are things that are happening right now, but trust me, years later, I think this book will still be very relevant. It says how they change the game, how retail went mobile. On one of the pages, she said the reasons I shop online, obviously chilling. She said a story about when her and her fiance right now go to the shop, he's covered in tattoos, and you know how you go to LV now, they're just looking at you. First of all, I think it was because I was black, and maybe broke too. So just avoid all that rubbish. She really loves to shop online in her 90. Everything will come. There are even online stores now that can deliver to you like 90 minutes, apparently. They are the ones you can even shop like after watching them on one week, as just start buying things like that. So the next chapter was be aware of the impact. It has to do with sustainability as well, and purchasing ethically, protecting your shopping habits, what to do with your used items. This is such a topic to me. Like, you see, when I was reading Heart and Hustle, like, so to it's always important, guys. Buy quality. Think about what you're buying before you buy. Just make sure, like, this turtleneck thing I'm wearing now, I think I had this thing 3 years ago. It was one top shop sale. I bought it in three quantities. I've not seen anyone as nice as this fitted on my body as this, and I've added with loss, with everything. It's still there. I'm still wearing it, rocking it. So it's always good to buy classic pieces that will last for you. Obviously, trends come, go, indulge, but small, because the environment is affected by things like this. Fast fashion is not really good. Rule three is be social. A lot of advice on Instagram, using hashtags, quality pictures, and she talks obviously about Pinterest. Guys, Pinterest is, I won't say it's underrated, because to be honest, I use it very well, but I just don't see, like, I've never gotten a job because my Pinterest has maybe 8,000 unique views. No brand has ever asked me what's your Pinterest following. Pinterest is a kind of Google, but it's for everything. And Pinterest is not just fashion, guys. DIYs, your home decor, cooking, sex, religion, so many things on Pinterest. Don't sleep on your Pinterest. From a blogger I follow, this thing called fashion, I think she wrote an ebook on Pinterest. I'll see if I can find a link and give you guys, because it's helpful if you don't know how to start off. You can pin your blog post on Pinterest as well. You can pin links there. So it's actually a superb platform. While she was telling you what to do and stuff, she also told you about real things that were happening then, now, and then how she foresees the future. Rule four, be culturally aware and diverse. This is quite explanatory. Admiring all shapes and sizes, obviously diversity, inclusivity, and she talked about the Time's Up hashtag. And for, you know, there's some companies that don't list one. Why she's saying this thing, she like now refers you to like, okay, these are the companies that don't put for. These are the six times inclusivity was really. This is not something I'll be telling you and reading to you. No, go and buy this book. It's a very nice information packed fashion book. Rule five was be innovative. Obviously, you're trying to be creative, try and do something in a different way. There's nothing new under the sun, as everyone will tell you, but there are new ways under the sun. Like, and then you can even create something from something that already exists, like just an innovative way of tackling something that already exists. The Nike ID customization, how Nike said, and then she talks about Sophia Amorosa. I don't know if I reviewed the book on here. So I sell it from eBay, like me. In fact, that's the reason I even bought the book. Like, I sell on eBay so much. The company crashed, obviously, both who are taking over, but it was a good story. Rule six is be the first to adopt. So guys, like when you see how IGTV just came up, people were just like, which one is this one, which one? In fact, I'm sure when Instagram came, people were just like, what kind of platform is this? Because I'm like, I don't even have energy. You have to adopt, especially when you're working in this kind of industry where you need people. Go and find out what's happening there. First mover's advantage. Open a page, try it. You never know, that might be where you hit it. You know, people that say YouTube, they're doing it for fun, they're having fun. I recommended people to follow, boss ladies to follow, sports people to follow, and fashion girls to follow. For the fashion girls to follow, I think I'll just read the list for you guys. Okay, she called it the most innovative fashion blogger. I don't know why my name was not there. I don't understand. So 15 of the most innovative fashion bloggers, fashion girls to follow, like girl bosses you need to follow, 9 models you need to follow, fashion ladies, fashion and mentoring collabs. There's an Alicia that had Patricia Bites in it. I think it was like bloggers to follow or something. But you guys go and buy the book. I'm not going to tell you anybody to follow you. Go and buy the book. There's also a list of different brands and their current creative directors, which I thought was really dope. This book now, I knew who started it. So some Nick Robertson. Also the person who started was Inna Tapote, Natalie Massenet. This is really nice book. I'll put all the price and the links to buy them in the more section of this post. This is my third book, and to be honest guys, I did not read this book. Look at the title, Capture Your Style by Amy Song, New York Times best. transform your Instagram photos, showcase your life, and build the ultimate platform. I didn't think I should, you know, spend my spare time reading it, because let's just open one random page and let me read something. So yeah, okay, these are pictures, which is a plus for me. The angle, the pose, the clarity, the distance, the ratio. There's this quotes I really like that she had here. There's no rule that says every outfit has to be head to toe look, and that's very true. There's one of my followers that actually DM'd one day. I was like, you always post your pictures head to toe, sometimes cut it, let's imagine what's under. You don't just, it's boring. Sometimes just cut it, give us a detail, give us the now, give us the full look. I just find it a bit more captivating than every day just one full head to toe. Let's open another random page. Become a storyteller. This is obviously for your caption. So the first one, the ins and outs of Instagram. Chapter 2, capture your style. Chapter 3, become a storyteller. The fourth one, find and grow your audience. Like, duh. Okay, I guess she was telling you how to do it. So she said hashtags versus geotag, what it all means. Everyone knows. I'm sure some people don't know what hashtags. To be honest, there are a lot of people that don't know the basic things in life, to be honest. So basic things on social media, it's crazy. When some people ask me the kind of question, I'm like, can't you just figure this thing out? But so I guess that's what the book is for. Loading conversation, timing is everything. Yeah, obviously there are times on Instagram that it's a good time to post, depending on where you are. There are days as well that are good time to post. I guess that's, well, I don't know if you wrote everything. I just talked about affiliate programs. That's obviously for bloggers and stuff, like reward style. Even Amazon has an affiliate program. eBay, I think so as well. WhatsApp is my IG. I really love your style. Once you get to 100 and something commission, they pay you, like, so it's just like lovely money that just comes randomly in the month. Working with brands, branded posts, takeovers, like these are things you do according to your style. Obviously, I don't know if she's telling you maybe how to, I don't even know next steps and account management. So this book is nice. It's like one of the things you can just have in your house for whenever you're just bored, just open and read, because there might be something you actually forget, there might be something you actually don't know. And the thing about Instagram or Instagram books is that Instagram changes the algorithm every damn time. So today you should put only 3 hashtags, tomorrow you should put caps, next tomorrow 10 million hashtags, another day if you didn't talk to this person you don't see the person. Like, yeah, there's too many rules, so you can't just sit down and just like have one thing you're following on Instagram. But then again, there are some things that are constants, like hashtags. I always advise people, like, if you're traveling, have a hashtag for that particular trip. Like some of my trips that I've done 5 years ago, I can search the pictures and still find them. So always use hashtags that are unique to you, so that you can find your pictures just for record purposes, and then when you're trying to contact a brand, to just see how you work before, for them to check your engagement and things like that. Yeah, but these are basic things. What I would say, to be honest, if you're a young girl, buy this one. It really guides you from like after college, and then it inspires you, kind of like how she puts a mistake there, where she grew, that she has a lot of inspirational quotes and stuff that could actually move you. So if you're 12 to maybe 22 or something like that, this would be really good for you. For this one, I think it's just something you should probably just have in the house, or maybe on your table when you're bored. Just open it, just look around. So your style showcase, outfit, shoes, and self is perfecting both. Like, just trying to do so much at the same time. But yeah, because you're already dressed up before you even got started. Anyway, I guess you use this to guide yourself with the way you're dressing. So grab this book, grab it. This is like a classic. There's a lot of real life facts, history, someone that knows their onions, and then advice, people to follow. Susie Bobo was at number one. When you talk about revolutionary bloggers, Susie Lau, and guess what guys, she follows me on Instagram. I hope you enjoyed this review of these 3 books. As I said, if there's one you're going to buy out of this, it should be this one, definitely. And then if you want to buy another one, this, and then maybe this, you can buy all 3, like me. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this. If you haven't subscribed, please do. I have so much amazing content for you. So click the like button. See you on the next episode. Bye bye.